Hello everybody, my name is Valentina and I'm bringing you this week's news from Manilva. First, the summary.
Manilva is setting an example for the whole of Andalusia in the field of environmental conservation. Last week, Manilva celebrated its pilgrimage in honour of Our Lady of Fatima. The town council has reached an agreement with local businesses regarding the taxes for the occupation of public spaces. The town council has been donated ornamental material to be used for the decoration during its many fiestas.
Manilva wants to set up an example in Andalusia regarding the conservation of unique environments. Some of Manilva's beaches, being declared as an ecological reserve, have started a series of initiatives aimed especially at the repopulation of these areas by native species of the plants, the elimination of non-indigenous species, and the cleaning of the sand dunes. In the last few days, technical experts from the Junta de Andalusia has visited our area to evaluate the progress of the work with the local representatives and to discuss such issues as the provision of traffic in these areas and the reposting of the reserve.
Setting an example regarding environmental conservation in Andalusia is the aim of the Municipal Department of the Environment of Manilva, led by the first Deputy Mayor Emilio López Berenguer, in light of the fact that some of our beaches have been officially declared as ecological reserves by the Junta de Andalusia. On these beaches, there are some plant species which are practically unique in the whole of Europe and have led to the replanting of these areas with native species, with the elimination of non-indigenous plants, as well as the cleaning and conservation of the sand dunes. Experts from the environment delegation of the Junta de Andalusia have been to Manilva to evaluate and assess the work that has been carried out up to now. Accompanied by Councillor Emilio López, Area Director Lola Ahumada, and staff from the Environment Department, they were able to inspect the work being carried out in situ and were very impressed with the firm commitment of the Municipal Environment Department in promoting the conservation of this natural area. Among the other issues discussed by both administrations were measures to be taken to prevent motor vehicles entering the areas and signposting the ecological reserve. All this work should be finished by mid-June, with the launch of an initiative called the Blue Trail, promoted by the Municipal Environment Department to raise awareness of this important environmental heritage. After the summer season, the next step would be to fence the whole perimeter of the ecological reserve in an environmentally friendly way, in addition to resuming the planting of native species and the removal of invasive flora. Work will continue for the next 3 years, which according to López Berenguer requires the joint efforts and work of the Junta de Andalucía, the Coastal Agency and the Municipal Environment Department, which according to López Berenguer will make Manilva an example in the field of environmental conservation.
On Saturday, 26th of May, 50 people have been evacuated from their homes in El Hacho because of a serious fire. Luckily, the consortium of provincial firefighters had everything under control by early afternoon. 5 hectares of brush and scrub were burned. None of the nearby houses suffered any damage inside, as though 5 houses have their wooden pergolas burnt.
On Saturday, the 26th of May, some residents in the El Hacho urbanization woke up to see the disturbing sight of a nearby green zone alongside their estate in flames, which were coming dangerously close to their houses. Some 50 people from 20 houses were evacuated as the fire came closer. The councillor for the environment, Emilio López, went to the area himself to see the magnitude of this inferno. Firefighters from the provincial consortium in Malaga managed to get the fire under control and protect the houses at about 4 in the afternoon on the same day, after 5 hectares of scrubland had gone up in flames. However, according to the firefighters, the only damage suffered to the houses was outside, with some wooden pergolas being damaged, as well as 1 palm tree. The fire started about 11 in the morning in the Las Brisas II part of El Hacho. And such was the ferocity of the flames and the intensity of the smoke, many residents from nearby houses were evacuated as a precaution. As well as personnel from the Malaga Firefighting Consortium, also at the scene were local police from Manilva, Autonomous Police, Guardia Civil, as well as members of Infoca.
The tax regarding the use of public space by restaurants, bars, etc. became applicable for the 11th of April this year and not from the beginning of the year. These agreements had made at the last meeting between the mayoress and the committee of local businesses from Manilva. What these were the bills that have a discount of more than 27%.
The mayoress Antonia Munoz and the Councillor for Commerce Diego Diaz had a meeting last week with representatives of the Manilva Business Association ACOEMA, where it was agreed that the taxes regarding the occupation of public spaces by bars and restaurants, etc., would be judged to have come into effect from the 11th of April, the date it was published in the Provincial Official Bulletin, and not from the beginning of the year, as is usually the case. This agreement for the current economic year will now give a discount of 27.86% on the corresponding bills, as this will only take into account the time period from the 11th of April to the 30th of December 2012. This percentage is thanks to the agreement supported by the Town Council, which decided to take into account the specific circumstances so far this year, when from the beginning of the season, normally Easter time, local businesses have shown a considerable decline in sales in comparison to other years, for which the weather did not help. For this reason, the mayoress, Antonia Munoz, has decided to increase this initial discount up to 50%, which according to Diego Diaz, instead of businesses having to pay for the whole year, they will now only be obliged to pay for half the year of 2012. A new tax has been introduced for permanent fixtures that have been erected on public space, which will have a reduction of 25% and affect mostly those businesses situated in Duquesa Port. Both Antonia Munoz and Diego Diaz have publicly thanked all local businessmen for the cordial atmosphere of these meetings and their mutual collaboration with the common objective of helping the business sector.
The Town Council has received ornamental material for fiestas donated by various local businesses for these events. Thanks to the effort made by the local Town Council and the renegotiation of debts with the suppliers, the Council has received the local arcs, a professional bridge, a stage, Christmas decoration, and even a decorative entrance.
The work done by the Department of the Mayoress in negotiating payment for outstanding bills to local businesses is already bearing fruit, as in the last few days, the Councillor for Finance and Youth, Marcos Ruiz, and the Councillor for Infrastructure and Sport, Mario Jimenez, have recently received various types of material from local businesses which can be used to adorn our many fiestas. According to Marcos, this is all thanks to negotiations on the part of the Mayoress Antonia Munoz and himself to pay council suppliers, as a result of which the council has been given 40 arcs of lights, a stage, a professional bridge of lights, numerous Christmas signs, and an entrance for the August fair, which have cost the town council nothing. Marcos pointed out that this will save the council a considerable amount of money, as normally this type of material has to be hired especially for every fiesta. The stage will be first used for the fiesta of San Juan in Sabanillas on the 23rd of June.
In the last few days, the Municipal Health Department has given the doctors of the municipality Emergency Health Service new uniforms to carry out the professional work. These substitute the old ones, which have deteriorated with the passage of the time.
The Councillor for Health of the Manilva Town Council, Emilio Lopez, has given the doctors of our Municipal Emergency Health Service new uniforms with which to carry out their work. These comprise of trousers, sweatshirts, vests and jackets. According to the Councillor, who is accompanied by his area director, Lola Ahumada, it was necessary to replace these uniforms of the local doctors as the old ones had deteriorated with the passing of time. Emilio went on to thank these professionals and the efforts they put in to provide the best possible health care for all the residents of our town.
Last weekend, our locality celebrated its traditional pilgrimage in honor of Our Lady of Fatima, organized jointly by the Culture Department and the Brotherhood of Manilva.
Last weekend, Manilva celebrated the pilgrimage in honor of Our Lady of Fatima. The event began on Saturday, the 26th of May, in the afternoon, with the procession carrying the Virgin from the Santa Ana Church in Manilva to the San Adolfo Hermitage beside Los Baños de la Hedionda. As well as the public, the procession also included the Equestrian Association of Manilva, the Brotherhood of Manilva, and municipal officials such as the Councillor for Culture Eva Galindo and Councillors Diego Urieta and Antonio Parra, among others. Once Our Lady of Fatima arrived at the Hermitage, a wreath was laid, accompanied by the prayers of the Rosary. During the evening, both local residents and people from nearby towns of all ages enjoyed the performance of the orchestra of the Manilva Municipal Music School. The festivities continued on Sunday the 27th of May with Holy Mass held in the chapel, officiated over by parish priest Nicolas Timpu with hymns sung by a local choir, after which everyone enjoyed paella that was especially prepared for the occasion. The mayoress Antonia Muñoz gave some beautiful words of remembrance of the late José Castillo, as well as thanking the work of everyone who had contributed to this pilgrimage. For her part, the Councillor for Culture Eva Galindo noted that this type of event brings together families who want to enjoy a pleasant day together, and went on to invite everyone to participate in this event next year. Finally, she expressed her satisfaction with the success of this year's pilgrimage.
The enrollment time is open up to the 15th of June for the summer sports program Patios de Verano, which once again is full of activities such as arts and crafts, theater, dancing, environment workshops, extracurricular classes and various sports activities. These are some of the things that the children between 3 and 12 years old can participate in.
The recreational sports activities for children are returning again this summer. This is an initiative launched by the Delegations of Education and Sports, led by Eva Galindo and Mario Jimenez respectively, and is aimed at children between 3 and 12 years of age. The activities will take place in the Pablo Picasso School in Manilva and the Mike Candil School in Sabaneers from the 2nd of July until the 31st of August, from 9 in the morning until 2 in the afternoon. There will also be an early morning class from 7:30 to 9 a.m. All those interested in participating in these activities should be aware that places are limited and the registration period is now open until the 15th of June. Enrollments can be made at the Education Department in the Plaza Martín Carpena beside the Manilva football ground or in the multiple-use building in Sabaneers, where one will have to present the necessary forms and pay the fees in cash. The prices depend on the times the children will be taking part in the activities and also whether they are registered or not in Manilva. This year, the canteen will be available for the children. Those children taking part will be able to enjoy educational activities such as arts and crafts, workshops, theatre, dance, environmental studies and special tutoring. They can also play sports, namely football, basketball and handball, as well as many other sports and water games and classes for coordination. For more information, all those interested can call either of the following telephone numbers: 952-89-1367 or 952-89-1532. And finally, Councillors Eva Galindo and Mario Jimenez hope that all these activities will help the children acquire more knowledge and skills as well as having great fun during the summer.
On the 25th of May, culture was the name of the game thanks to the presentation of the book of short stories called And Everything Thanks to You by Dolores Loizaga. Showing great emotion, the author explained her work, which was dedicated especially to her father.
The 25th of May was a very special day for local resident Dolores Loizaga, who was visibly emotional as she talked about her book of short stories called And Everything Thanks to You in Via Matilde. This work is dedicated to her father and contains biographical and fictional stories based on the experiences of several people. The authoress was supported by many members of the public, her family, friends, neighbors, and aficionados of literature and municipal officials. During the presentation of her book, her husband and her daughter read extracts from her work. Also present at the event were the delegate of the National Union of Authors from the Campo de Gibraltar, Nuria Ruiz, and literary expert from Algeciras, Dario Jurado, well known for his role in the TV show The Good Law, in addition to the mayoress Antonio Muñoz and the councillor for culture Eva Galindo, who described the event as very endearing. For her part, the mayoress Antonio Muñoz, to whom the authoress dedicated a copy of the book, congratulated Dolores on her work and described the event as very important for our municipality. During the event, everyone enjoyed a flamenco show by Nieves Rojas and an aperitif.
News to follow includes the 5th Spring Festival of Rhythmic Gymnastics Villa de Manilva, the celebration of the famous party and the allocation of places for the nursery school in Manilva, Sabinillas and the Castillo. All this to follow in the next few minutes.
According to the Education Department led by Eva Galindo, a total of 172 children have obtained places in the nursery schools in Manilva, Sabaneers and El Castillo for the academic year 2012 to 2013. The official list was published on the 24th of May in line with the established protocol. In total, there are 214 places available, so anyone not included can apply from the 9th of July for one of the 42 remaining places. Marcos Reith, the councillor for youth, was very pleased with the number of the younger population who turned up for the famous party in the multiple-use pavilion in Manilva. Sergio Tla, who takes part in the popular television program Women, Men and Vice Versa, was a star of the show. Also taking part was a violinist, Alex Medina, and DJs Nathan and Horny Gold, as well as a spectacular laser beam show and go-go dancers. This famous party in Manilva 2012 was organized by the Fantasy Group Production Company in collaboration with the Municipal Youth Department. And finally, the Las Vinas Municipal Pavilion hosted the 5th Via de Manilva Spring Rhythmic Gymnastics Festival. This event was organized by the sports department led by Mario Jimenez and was a great success both in terms of its organization and the standard of the participants. Those clubs taking part came from Algeciras, La Línea, Los Barrios, Palmones, Tesorillo, Gibraltar, Ronda, Mijas and Manilva. In the afternoon, the clubs from Tesorillo, Palmones and Manilva all performed. The tournament took place with both individual and double performances, with all those taking part receiving a medal.
That was all for today. Thank you for watching and hope to see you here next week.